And now, live in studio, cutting through your typical media nonsense and offering you a rational and unbiased perspective on current events and life in Tampa Bay, he's a successful entrepreneur, a real estate and finance expert, and goes to bat for you every day as your consumer advocate. Your host, Brandon Rhymes.
Yes, here we are again another day committed to picking a fight with the mainstream media and providing you the timely truth centered around your real estate, credit, finance, estate planning, tax planning, and so much more. You're listening to the Consumer Quarterback Show, where our number one goals remain. We're going to educate, we're going to entertain, we're going to enlighten, but most importantly, we want to engage you in an effort to help you win in any marketplace.
The only thing I'm addicted to right now is winning.
Now I want you to pull out your smartphone, save our consumer advocate hotline number in your phone. It's 813-917-1894.
You used to call me on my cell phone.
813-917-1894. Baby. Don't forget our number, and we want you to bookmark our website, consumerqb.com. Consumerqb.com. That's our website, blog site, a plethora of information available for you at our website, as well as you can watch the live stream. You can see links to all of our expert contributors, the finest folks in the Gulf Coast region that we've assembled, we've vetted, and we put together to help you win. We don't care if you're climbing a corporate ladder or if you throw a ladder in your truck on the way to work. This show's for you. We're going to entertain, we're going to educate and enlighten, and we have a QAA formula with this show. You're going to have questions as consumers. We're going to provide you answers, but we want to take it a step further and provide you these action items on ways that you can live a better life. And this segment is brought to you by the official hotel partner of the Quarterback Show. It's Kipton's, the Hotel Zamora. Beautiful St. Petersburg, beautiful waterfront property here on the intercoastal side of St. Petersburg. Excellent, excellent staycation opportunity in St. Petersburg. The Hotel Zamora, Kipton's, the Hotel Zamora. They also have a great restaurant. The Castile is the restaurant there. Excellent food. They had some great paella the other weekend we were there, and it's a great, great hotel partner, as well as Back In Health Massage. Big shout out to Michael Vogt with Back In Health Massage, helping people with neck, back, shoulder, hip, and leg pain feel better. And my massage therapist, Michael Vogt, voted top 10 massage services in Tampa Bay by the readers of the Tampa Bay Business Journal's Best in the Biz Awards. So in studio, we have a special guest, Mr. Mayor Cretekos, Mayor George Cretekos of Clearwater, in the studio. Welcome back in, sir.
Oh, thank you, Brandon. It's good to be here right before Christmas and to be able to wish you and all the listeners a very merry Christmas and happy holiday season.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a great time of year. It's that time of year where folks are goal setting. They're looking at 2017. They're kind of reflecting back to 2016, seeing where they can make improvements. And yeah, it's just a great time of year. Also in studio, Matthew Fonk, Cavalier Estates LLC, property management partner on the Quarterback Show. Welcome back in, sir.
Thank you, sir. Glad to be here. Awesome to be with the mayor.
Yeah, absolutely. It's going to be a fun show. Also in studio, but cannot talk today, is Abe. Abe with Total Title Solutions. He lost his voice, but he's here. He's here in studio. And, you know, he's and he's trying, but, you know, also has an awesome restaurant, Abe's Place, over there in Clearwater as well. And we're doing something different now. We're starting off the show with a little two-minute huddle. Call that audible for you. But I just wanted to let you know a little bit about Pareto's principle. It's a way that you can really streamline your business. And interesting story is Wilfredo Pareto. He's an Italian economist back in the day, 1895. And he discovered that 80% of the land was owned by 20% of the people, right? So, you know, and that relates to your business, to your relationships. It relates to a lot of the things in life that are either good or bad. So when you think about Pareto's principle, it's also known as the 80-20 rule, right? So, and it's also the principle of least effort. So 80% of your business most of the time is going to come from 20% of your top clients, you know, if you think about that situation. And it relates to success, you know, and you want to focus your energy there. You know, identify what's the big difference and focus your energy on those tasks that are going to help you win and help you have a better business, help you have a better relationship, help you earn more sales in 2017. So success, the progressive realization of a worthy cause. So big shout out to from the past there, Wilfredo Pareto. So interesting story, Pareto's principle. So let's go ahead and jump into this great content. Mayor Cretekos, thanks for coming in today. And what's new over in Clearwater?
Oh, lots of things are going on. On the beach especially, but also in downtown. We have some consultants who've been in town to come up with an imagined Clearwater. We just celebrated our centennial last year, and so now we're looking into the next century, and we're, you know, trying to figure out what's the best plans that we can implement in the next several years to revitalize the downtown area, and especially our Coachman Park area, where we have lots of land available to us, and just see what can we do to attract people to come into downtown. Fortunately, and this will be of interest to you, we have some new developments that are coming on board with rentals and also condominiums in the downtown area. The Skyview Project right in downtown, across the street from the Capitol Theater. And then a little further up on Cleveland Street, the Nolan is a project of apartment rentals that we're looking forward to open maybe by the end of the month, but more than likely for sure in January, the first phase of it. And so whenever you have people, and y'all know this better than I, whenever you have people living in an area, that generates some enthusiasm and an excitement, and we're looking forward to having that help us transform the downtown area. We've also most recently been working with a lot of our small businesses to try to encourage young people who are in the tech industry and the software. We've got a couple of new companies that have expanded recently, Know Before and Auto Loop. They made downtown Clearwater their home, and they've been expanding. In fact, last week we were at a function at one of our local parks, and the owner of Know Before came and said, "Remember last year you challenged me to have 100 employees working in Clearwater by 2016? Well, we now have 200 employees,
Nice.
So that's good news, because those are the kinds of stories that don't necessarily get out, into the public. And,
sure.
and it's good to know that we are beginning to turn the corner. It's a slow process. The magic wand, it just doesn't work like a fairy tale.
It's a lot like business, right?
Right.
There's no overnight success. It's, it's long, hard hours, work hours, So if you just joined us, I'm Brandon Rimes. I'm your host. We're having a chat here with Clearwater Mayor George Cretekos on the Consumer Quarterback Show. And, a couple things came to mind. When you think about a downtown area, more and more people are wanting that walkability of a right. downtown area. And then also, I love Freedom Boat Club. I go out and take the boats out on the weekends. A little less this time of year, but it's still great to go out nonetheless. But, every time I go out and I come right through Shepherd's there underneath the bridge over the Sankey Bridge there, and coming out, and I look back and I see all this development going on in Clearwater Beach. Man, it's amazing.
We're looking forward to Dr. Patel's property, the Wyndham Grand, opening in January. He's got plans for a big grand opening the middle of January, and I know events have already been booked there. So that will help us, make Clearwater and its beach is already the number one beach in the country.
Yeah.
But it will help not only Clearwater, but also the entire Tampa Bay area, because
Absolutely.
People will come to realize that Pinellas County, that Tampa, is a cohesive group working together promoting each other.
That's right.
When we do that, it's like the football. When you're doing that, you've got a successful run for a championship, and that's what we're trying to do.
Yeah, I love it.
Speaking of champion, Brandon, you need to tell us about that. We're going to have the national championship game and the Outback Bowl back-to-back. Abe here has just been such a good supporter of our sports tourism in Clearwater, whether it's with the Phillies and the Threshers, but all the events that we have at the Clearwater High School and Countryside. Abe and his team is right there. It's just great to have this kind of synergy throughout our community and area.
Yeah, I love it. A lot of big things happening in Tampa Bay, St. Pete, Clearwater. I call it the best place in the United States of America. We talk about the beaches. We talk about the professional sports. And then to be able to host, and a lot of people that are sports fans, you think about, you talk about NFL football, but they have a passion for college football.
Oh, yeah.
So to have that national championship game here right at Raymond James, my friends and I, we have a party house close to the stadium, tailgate house, so we're looking forward to that day. And, the big question is who's going to be in that game, right?
Well, I guess that is a question, depending on I'm looking at it from a standpoint of I want it to be cold up north and snowing so that no matter who's here, when the bands are on Clearwater Beach parading barefoot in the sugar sand.
Yeah.
You know, you have that image going back. You know, people are going to want to come here and eat in our restaurants and stay in our hotels and help our businesses.
Yeah, we like that. You know, as the owner of a real estate brokerage here in Tampa Bay and, you know, loving to work with sellers, you know, it's a great time to buy and sell and real estate and invest in real estate. So, yeah, hey, stay with us. Don't touch that dial. More from Clearwater Mayor George Cretekos on the quarterback show here, as well as we're going to bring Matthew Fonk into the Cavalier States into the conversation. And here's an interesting story as well. See where J.D. Power ranks Tampa International Airport. Interesting story from the Tampa Bay Business Journal. And more from our expert contributors here in studio. And we're going to talk about a little bit more about some football things happening here in Tampa Bay. A lot of the growth in Clearwater, particularly Clearwater Beach, and everyone's favorite dolphin over there as well. We'll talk about the dolphin tail. And so stay with us. Don't touch that dial. You're listening to the Consumer Quarterback Show, ConsumerQB.com.
Enjoy tranquil seclusion in an eco-lover's paradise. Paddling through the mangroves where the only sounds you'll hear are the sounds of nature. Because you deserve to relax on vacation, visit Pasco County, Florida.
If you were injured in a car crash, what would you do first? Who would you call?
You claim to be injured, yet you spoke to and saw an attorney before you saw a doctor. Is that true?
Yes.
Lawyers on TV tell you to call them first. You can, but should you? The law has changed, and you may find yourself paying your own medical bills if you don't see a doctor in the first 14 days. If you've been in a car crash, you need MyCrashMD, the interactive doctor visit, where you can consult virtually with a physician after you've been hurt in a car accident.
We can see you today. We'll take great care of you, regardless if you are at fault or not.
MyCrashMD is an actual medical visit with a doctor. No waiting in an ER, no wasting time driving around town. Download MyCrashMD free from anywhere and then see a doctor on any mobile device. Times are changing. If you don't get medical attention within the first 14 days after your crash, you could lose your insurance benefits. So if you've been in a car crash, help yourself and your accident case with MyCrashMD.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Rimes here, former USF football player, played on the inaugural football team at the University of South Florida under Coach Jim Leavitt, and love to see the Bulls, you know, improving every year. 10-2 record so far this year. Got the Birmingham Bowl coming up, and just hired Coach Charlie Strong. Taggart's off to Oregon. Charlie Strong is in Tampa Bay now. So, and also a published author. Just published my second book here. It's Become the MVP in Your Industry by Surfing the Radio Waves, helping business owners and professionals understand and learn how to start their own radio show, harness the power of the media, and also co-authored by Connor Anthony as well, our show producer here. So some great content on the show as well as in our book. Helping you win in any marketplace is the goal of our show. And Hula Bay is our official restaurant partner here in Tampa Bay. It's a big shout out to Hula Bay. Waterfront ambiance in South Tampa here. Excellent food, wonderful sushi, and a great staff. Say hello to Mike Finnegan and his team down at Hula Bay right here in South Tampa, Tyson Avenue, and let them know the quarterback sent you for a free water with lemon. He's going to hook you up every time you go in. Got a special deal going for you. So I got a couple of hot listings I want to let you know about as well. 7814 Sims Road in Gibsonton. This is a property that is almost five acres, and it has a $2,000 income-producing asset in the form of a commercial property attached to it, as well as a completely remodeled four-bedroom, three-bath property listing here, 3,500 square feet at $449,000. 7814 Sims Road in Gibsonton, great opportunity, as well as 514 Broxburn Avenue in Temple Terrace, four-bedroom, two-bath, $214,000, completely remodeled single-family home in the USF District, and a great buying opportunity in beautiful Tampa Bay. All right. So we've got in studio to my right, Mayor George Cretekos of Clearwater. And to my left, we've got Matthew Fonk, Cavalier Estates LLC, property management partner, longtime friend of the program. And also in studio's Abe with Total Title Solutions and Abe's Place. But he's a little hampered today, doesn't have his voice, but he's in spirit. So he's here in spirit. So, Mr. Cretekos, let's talk. I want to come back to you and talk about the random act of kindness, something we've been doing on our show for quite a while now. But I want to go ahead and bring Matthew Fonk into the conversation. Matt, what are you seeing out there, and what, do you have any questions for the mayor?
Oh, no, he actually commented stuff about Clearwater. I thought it was neat that they're actually doing some things that are trying to bring certain areas back. You know, like he says, you bring in the people, it's a vibe, and it warms everything up, and commerce happens. And when commerce happens, people have money to spend and enjoy, and you know, that's what we like to see in the communities.
That's right.
I work a lot of different communities that are really high-end and some low-end stuff, so it's just fun and challenging, but you know, they all – in the end of the day, the rental, the tenants really want to just have a nice, peaceful life and
that's right,
and enjoy. So, yeah, other than that, property management's doing well. It's still a good industry right now. I think houses are still kind of selling as well. Yeah. And we have, you know, great systems of what we're doing, and we're seeing a lot of people renting homes, and the stuff that we're renting is providing nice homes for people who are in really struggling to move at this point in life. A lot of the people I work with are, you know, they have about three times the rent of income, and they're really like lower end type. And so we work with them over payment periods and plans and so forth to get them in. But there's still a lot of good people out there renting homes that don't want to own. And there's people that are moving out of our homes that are buying. So
right,
all good or all around.
Yeah, it seems to be, you know, sometimes it's that circle. You know, it's that circle of life. The economic conditions change. Different situations happen. And, property management, we want you reaching out to Matt Fonk here, Cavalier Estates LLC, the best in the business, helps you as a rental guarantee. And, you know, a lot of ways that he can help you if you are in that position and you don't want to manage this inventory. And maybe, you know, it's a great opportunity. You look at the Harvard study showing the rents are rising. You know, Tampa, St. Pete, Clearwater, the rents are rising. It's a great opportunity for an investment. On yesterday's show, we had Scott Maurer with Advanta IRA in studio talking about how you can leverage the real estate by, you know, not only by purchasing it off market or purchasing through Networth Realty, one of our partners on the wholesale side, but when you put it into your IRA. So, yeah, so we appreciate you tuning in here to the Quarterback Show. Let's go back to Clearwater Mayor George Cretekos here. And, you know, one of the things I love is the service aspect. You know, every time we visit, we touch with each other. I know you've been on the show a few times. I've been over to your office. But, you know, you have this great investment back into the community and that random act of kindness. I love that.
Yeah, Brandon, you brought that up, you know, earlier, and it's just one of those things that I have truly believed in, that, you know, if you're going to be a public servant, then you need to lead by example. And one of the things that you can do is, you know, like each one of us, especially during this holiday season, takes a moment aside to give back to the community in one way or another, be it your chair, you know, a favorite charity or your church, or just a neighbor who's lending a hand. Last week, I was with some kids from Countryside High School, and they used their own money to go out and go shopping for kids in a daycare center in a Head Start program. They shopped specifically for that individual and gave them a gift that they would have to open on Christmas Day that they normally wouldn't have. They didn't want any credit. They were just quietly doing this. And that's what this random act of kindness, you know, that you're talking about, something that's close to my heart as a regular blood donor. I want to encourage people to consider, you know, who are healthy and who can give blood, you know, just do it once a year. If everybody who could do that would just donate blood once a year, then we wouldn't have shortages and we wouldn't have the need to do these pleas. Because, you know, I look at it from the standpoint of it's like a health insurance policy. I give blood so I don't get sick. You know, Abe, maybe if you give blood, you won't lose your voice. You know, it's worth a shot. You know, it's sort of this, you know, random act of kindness.
Sure.
And I know my wife, you know, my wife doesn't like needles. I have to go hold her hand when she gets her flu shot. That's why I have to give blood so often, because she doesn't. But I would encourage people to, you know, whether it's giving blood or donating to your charity or just helping people, that makes you feel good. And like I say, that story about the kids from Countryside High School just resonated with me, especially last week when they did it, and now as we're approaching Christmas on Sunday.
Yeah, absolutely. Mayor Cretekos here on the Quarterback Show, Mayor George Cretekos of Clearwater. And so we're talking about, too, with the random act of kindness, is something as simple as boxing up the leftover groceries that you have in your fridge that may be close to expiring, or maybe leftovers you had, taking that and you know, putting it on your vehicle. That way on your commute to and from work or wherever you drive daily, you know, you see those folks that are on the side of the road that are down on their luck. That's an easy way to contribute to society and be a force for good in the community. Something as easy as donating blood, you know, if you don't like that aspect of it. But you know, we want to help out. We want to, you know, be that force for good in the community. We want to be your consumer advocate, and we want you to think of this show as the hub of your financial wheel, each spoke extending out, representing another one of our preferred partners, the finest folks in all of Tampa Bay and the Gulf Coast region. And we're talking about business, credit, finance, estate planning, tax planning, all types of different companies that we can help you win. But you've got to make the call. And it's 813-917-1894.
Welcome to my house. 813-917-1894. Nothing can stop me.
And, you know, we like our buttons around here. We have a little fun with you. But, you know, it's a way that you can give back to society. You can contribute. And I like, you know, something resonated with me. And I think I've told this story a couple of times as I'm talking, and we just went through the political system here, or the nauseating political cycle, is you know, the change in politics, how, you know, earlier in your career, we only have a couple minutes left on this segment, but maybe when we come back, you could maybe give us some perspective you know, it seems like a little bit of the respect has left from politics from earlier generations to now. You know, versus what you're seeing now, and I think a lot of it too is to do with the media cycle, how it's 24/7 and it's in your face all the time.
You're absolutely correct, and that sums it up, Brandon. People have really used the internet and cell phones and whatever that just whatever you do now becomes instantaneous news, and sometimes it's difficult to correct an erroneous thought. It's harder to do that,
right.
And that's why, you know, our mantra has always been just be honest and open with the people, because, you know, if Richard Nixon had been honest and said, yeah, they did it, yep, Watergate never would have happened.
Right.
You know, I mean, it would have been the end of the story. But when you start, I tell kids this all the time. We all at some point don't necessarily tell the truth. Mm-hmm. But if you don't tell the truth, then you have to remember what lie you told to every individual, because otherwise you may not be saying the same lie. And so it's always a whole lot easier just to tell the truth.
That's right. Yeah. Be upfront, be, you know, have that integrity. But so we saw that in the political cycle, and this obviously is not a political show. It's more about helping consumers. But, you know, I found that interesting, the story you told last time too. I think it was about how Tip O'Neill worked with the other side of the, you know,
Congressman Young that I used to work with.
Congressman Young. Yeah. Maybe we'll share a little bit of some of those stories when we come back and kind of reflect a little bit about the good old days, maybe. Right. If you don't mind. And also, we're going to talk about J.D. Power ranks Tampa International Airport. Find out what number we ranked here in Tampa Bay, and more from our expert contributors. We've got Matthew Fonk, Cavalier Estates LLC, property management partner on the Quarterback Show when we come back. So stay with us. Don't touch that dial. You're listening to the Consumer Quarterback Show, ConsumerQB.com.
Enjoy tranquil seclusion in an eco-lover's paradise. Paddling through the mangroves where the only sounds you'll hear are the sounds of nature. Because you deserve to relax on vacation, visit Pasco County, Florida.
If you were injured in a car crash, what would you do first? Who would you call?
You claim to be injured, yet you spoke to and saw an attorney before you saw a doctor. Is that true?
Yes.
Lawyers on TV tell you to call them first. You can, but should you? The law has changed, and you may find yourself paying your own medical bills if you don't see a doctor in the first 14 days. If you've been in a car crash, you need My Crash MD, the interactive doctor visit, where you can consult virtually with a physician after you've been hurt in a car accident.
We can see you today. We'll take great care of you, regardless if you are at fault or not.
My Crash MD is an actual medical visit with a doctor. No waiting in an ER, no wasting time driving around town. Download My Crash MD free from anywhere and then see a doctor on any mobile device. Times are changing. If you don't get medical attention within the first 14 days after your crash, you could lose your insurance benefits. So if you've been in a car crash, help yourself and your accident case with My Crash MD.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Rimes here, host of The Quarterback Show. This segment is brought to you by the Maids Cleaning Service. They do a great job cleaning our real estate properties. Big shout out to the Maids Cleaning Service. They are referred for a reason. 24-hour, 100% satisfaction guaranteed by the Maids Cleaning Service. They do a great job cleaning our real estate properties, as well as a big shout-out to Robert Hessel and his team over at Source One Solutions Security Partner. So business, finance, or business office, they can help you with your security needs, automation. Big shout-out to Robert Hessel and his team with Source One Solutions, longtime partner on the show over 3 years now, and they do a great job on all the security needs for our listeners. And I got a hot listing. I just reduced this property down $75,000 just yesterday, 8203 U.S. Highway 301 South in Riverview. It's a commercial opportunity, corner lot, commercial property here in downtown Riverview. Just reduced. The owner called me and said, hey, I want to get aggressive on this property and sell it quickly, so I reduced it down. And now it's got 30 parking spaces, and it's currently operating as a restaurant at 8203 U.S. Highway 301 South in Riverview. Great buying opportunity. Again, reduced $75,000 down to $525,000 here in beautiful Tampa Bay. All right. So Matthew Fonk, Cavalier Estates LLC, what else are you seeing out there, man?
Well, you know, we partnered with another company that does home inspections just for the move in and move outs.
Yep.
And we're doing it on a trial basis, and they're all set up with the apps and all that kind of thing. But we've found that it's offered us a lot better transition from one tenant to the next. And when a tenant does move out, having that person, that company go in and do that allows us a non-biased situation, so when they do contest the security deposit, we're able to provide a report with over 150-some pages of pictures and photos and documentation. And we can go back to them and say, here you go. Because in Florida, if you the law is really strange when it comes to lawsuits and real estate. They can get like triple the cost of attorney's fees billed back to you. It's really insane, I
wow.
think. So it's not just whatever the attorney fees are, it could be triple. So you have to be really cautious on what you choose to fight and what you don't choose
to
fight.
Punitive damage. It sounds like punitive damages.
The punitive damages, I think, could be tripled, and it's really crazy, and so can lawyers' fees. So yeah, a lot of times you're better off just stroking a check back to the tenant, even though they got you. But unless you really got good documentation,
right,
you know you got a good case. So that's why we brought in a company that does that. And I'll have to see if they'd like to join our show. They probably would. Stuff like that is where we're starting to actually add value to our business, for our clients as well. So
yeah, that's awesome. Makes it easy, and it takes some of that process, the legality process, makes you sleep at night. You know, anything that makes you sleep better at night is a good thing, right?
Well, yeah, and you know, you guys are talking about make yourself feel good. You know, if you're down and out, the best thing you can do is help somebody else. You know, believe it or not, it'll make you feel really good.
Yeah,
and that itself will make. You know, it fights when you're ill. It helps your immune system. All that stuff comes full circle. And, you know, whether we give up a late fee, I had one just disappear the other day, and a lady goes, I need to pay my late fee. It was $58. And I said, she goes, but it's not there. And she goes, I want to pay it. And I logged into the computer. I said, well, Merry Christmas. I don't know where it went, and I'm the only person that can reverse them. So I don't know if Santa Claus just, I have no idea. So I said, you know, maybe you weren't late. I don't know. But Merry Christmas. You know, it made me feel good. She writes back. She goes, my son can get the toy now that I wanted to get him. I mean.
Oh, that's nice.
It was $58. You know, I don't know about you guys. It's not a lot of money to probably me on any day given a week. It's a lot of money. But for some people, that's a third of their paycheck.
It's a lot. Yeah.
So
that's a random act of kindness. And, right. And you know, you see it come back. We had someone come in a couple weeks ago, brought in cupcakes to the show. They said, you always talk about the random act of kindness. They came in and they brought some cupcakes into the show. So it was pretty neat. they were pretty good, too. But we're back here in studio live from iHeartRadio. I'm your host, Brandon Rimes. I'm the owner of Platinum MVP Realty and a top listing agent here in Tampa Bay. And you just heard from Matthew Fonk. He's the owner of Cavalier Estates LLC, property management expert and a longtime friend of the program as well. And our special guest today, Clearwater Mayor George Cretekos here in studio. So what else are you seeing out there?
Well, we're excited in Clearwater about a couple things, but I want to go back to something that you had said earlier, if I can, and that's to talk about, you know, Tampa Airport. You know, we're jumping ahead here. I can't imagine how Tampa Airport is not number one in the country.
I mean,
Joe Lapano and his team have done such a good job in promoting the entire area and bringing in these international flights, which, you know, a few years ago, international tourism in the Bay Area just wasn't happening, and Mr. Lapano and his staff has gone out and brought in some extra flights to Zurich and to Frankfurt. And I know that that has made a big difference in Pinellas County and Clearwater, you know, helping our beach hotels market themselves on an international basis.
In Cuba now, too, right?
Cuba just started, I guess, last week. I don't know. I think I share some of Mayor Buckhorn's concerns about, you know, the Cuba situation, only because if travel to Cuba becomes really cheap, then people may not come to the Tampa Bay area.
Right.
And so I think we have to be careful in how we promote travel to Cuba, because we want those staycations to stay here as opposed to going to Cuba.
Yeah, that's an interesting point. I didn't, you know, think about that. You know, you think about it personally. I'd like to visit it maybe, and it seems like a cheap Southwest flight. But, yeah, the economic impact on Tampa Bay. Well, let's go ahead and jump into the story then. So it says J.D. Power ranks Tampa International Airport, even with nearly $1 billion expansion underway, Tampa International Airport snagged second place in the J.D. Power 2016 North America Airport Satisfaction Study. So TIA lost out to Portland, Oregon, which came in the first out of 31 large airports that were compared. The 636-page report, traveler satisfaction based on six factors: airport accessibility, check-in, baggage check process, security check, and we were number one in that spot, shopping, terminal facilities, and baggage claim. So interesting, you know, a very interesting point. But yeah, I think, you know, everybody I talk to, I do a lot of traveling, and, you know, Tampa is just such a breeze. You're in and out.
Yeah. It's a beautiful airport.
Yeah. It's rigged. It's rigged.
We'll get it next year when all the work's done.
We're doing all those improvements that they're doing in the main terminal and with the remote shuttle, so that we should be number one next year.
Yep.
Yeah. And so let's also bring up too, Mayor Cretekos, you were involved with that movie, The Dolphin Tale Part 2, I think it was. Is that right?
We had Dolphin Tale 1 and Dolphin Tale 2. What's best about all of that is that they're now working on a possibility of doing some TV shows. They're doing some remote access shows where you can go on the internet and actually see some of the educational programs that the Marine Aquarium features. But the stars have also repeatedly come back to Clearwater because they have fallen in love not only with our community, but also with the story of Winter and Hope. You know, I joke that my favorite movie is The Sound of Music, because when you didn't have to think, you could just sit back and relax and sing along with Julie Andrews and just feel good when it was over with. And that's the kind of movie Dolphin Tale is. When you leave, you feel good. You have hope. You have excitement. You know that things can get better if you work for it. And you don't have to think, and you don't go away depressed and, well, now what did this mean or what did that mean when you see some of these movies? Dolphin Tale has done not only a good job in promoting the Tampa Bay area and Clearwater, it is also, and we have to remember, and the aquarium reminds us of this, that its core mission isn't tourism, but its core mission is rescue, release, and rehab. And that's what they do every day. And by getting all these tourists to come in and see the aquarium, to see Winter, to see Hope, then they understand how important it is for each one of us to be good stewards of the environment.
Yeah, no, absolutely. It sure is. And I wanted to talk to you again with the political side of, you know, things happening that we just saw. You know, one of the things that came up, and maybe you can shed some light on it, is these sanctuary cities. You know, the issue with a sanctuary city and immigration, and you have sometimes you have, I guess, criminal activity happening in these sanctuary cities. Is that something that you're abreast to talk about?
Well, we every community, and I don't care whether you're in Florida or whether you're San Francisco or New York, every community has illegal aliens, people who have come into the country, whether legally and overstayed or whether they have come in illegally. Mm-hmm. So it is a problem that we have to address. And that's the difficulty. But the sanctuary city is one where we're saying that the police department will not cooperate with the federal officials in doing their job. In Clearwater, you know, we do have people who are here who have overstayed, but the immigration department has been handling that. They haven't asked us to interfere. We haven't. We try to reach out to them to make sure that they understand what they have to do to become.
Coming up on a break, I want to, but we'll dive back into that when we come back. But stay with us. You're listening to the Consumer Quarterback Show, consumerqb.com.
Enjoy tranquil seclusion in an eco-lover's paradise. Paddling through the mangroves where the only sounds you'll hear are the sounds of nature. Because you deserve to relax on vacation, visit Pasco County, Florida.
If you were injured in a car crash, what would you do first? Who would you call?
You claim to be injured, yet you spoke to and saw an attorney before you saw a doctor. Is that true?
Yes.
Lawyers on TV tell you to call them first. You can, but should you? The law has changed, and you may find yourself paying your own medical bills if you don't see a doctor in the first 14 days. If you've been in a car crash, you need My Crash MD, the interactive doctor visit, where you can consult virtually with a physician after you've been hurt in a car accident.
We can see you today. We'll take great care of you, regardless if you are at fault or not.
My Crash MD is an actual medical visit with a doctor. No waiting in an ER, no wasting time driving around town. Download My Crash MD free from anywhere and then see a doctor on any mobile device. Times are changing. If you don't get medical attention within the first 14 days after your crash, you could lose your insurance benefits. So if you've been in a car crash, help yourself and your accident case with My Crash MD.
We'll be right back.
All right, welcome back. Thanks for sticking with us. Brandon Rimes here, owner of Platinum MVP Realty and a top listing agent in Tampa Bay. Featured in Florida Realtor Magazine, Top Agent Magazine, Business Journal, and the Tribune. Recognized for innovation with marketing, helping our sellers profit more on the sale of their real estate properties. If you're a seller out there on the fence of selling or would at least want to know what the value of your property is, we would love to hear from you. Shoot us a call or text the word value to our hotline at 813-917-1894. We'll let you know the value of your real estate property and also do a free comparable market analysis. Basically the same thing that you pay $500 for an appraisal. We'll do it for you for free. We'll help you out with that. And we're back here in studio live from My Heart, and we're talking about a hot property here, 15102 Lake Magdalene Boulevard, 5 bedrooms, 3 bath, Carrollwood area, lake property, ski lake, balcony view, waterfront home, pool and spa, 5 bedrooms, 3 bath, and it's in the Carrollwood area and a great buying opportunity, almost 3,500 square feet, listed at $570,000. Great buying opportunity here in beautiful Tampa Bay.
No shoes, no shirt, and no problem.
All right, we're back here in studio, and we're talking with Clearwater Mayor George Cretekos in studio, as well as Matthew Fonk, owner of Cavalier Estates, LLC, property management expert, partner on the show as well. And, Mayor, I'll let you continue. I know it's kind of a difficult topic, but, I find it's interesting when I look on the news and you have all this. This is a big issue, and, I guess the bigger issue is that sometimes they commit crimes, and then, it's a very tough issue.
It is, but when you commit a crime, it makes the difference whether you're legal or illegal. You should not be committed the crimes, and you should be prosecuted to the fullest extent of the law. Back to the illegal who is still here. A lot of, we have to remember, especially with service industries, a lot of them do jobs that you and I wouldn't do.
Right.
And, just to kick somebody out, to kick them out, may not be the best solution. But that doesn't mean to say that we should not have a process where you can come into the country legally and make sure that you follow the steps to become a citizen. I know, many years ago, my grandmother came from Greece. She was 12 years old. She arrived the day before she was expected, so there was nobody at Ellis Island to meet her. She eventually, she never graduated high school. She never really learned the English language that well. But she could sell you. She had a little gift shop at the Sponge Docks in Tarpon Springs. Mm-hmm. And she could probably sell you the shirt off your back, because she knew her business. Yeah. And so you can't just, with a wide brush, say everybody who's illegal is bad and we need to throw them out of the country.
Yeah.
And that's what we have to be careful about. Yeah. And hopefully, our representatives in Washington and our president-elect will work toward that goal of making sure that we have a process that is fair and equitable for everybody.
Yeah, absolutely. We are a country of immigrants. My grandparents, first generation from Portugal, my dad's side, my mom's side's Irish. I mean, so we all are, at some point, if you trace the tree back far enough, a country of immigrants. I think what happens is when you hear the stories about the ones that are committing crimes and being, they're coming back and then they're able to commit crime after crime, that's where, potentially I see an issue. But
we shouldn't allow that. Absolutely correct,
yeah.
Brandon.
Yeah, absolutely. So, all right, well, let's open it up for questions. Matt, anything else that you want to talk about with the mayor, or any questions you think would be topical?
No, I'm cool. I appreciate him coming in, and again, I'm glad I got the chance to come in and just say hi. And, I don't know. I know that there was something going on a couple of months back with the aquarium you had mentioned. I don't know if you guys were looking for a new location or something. I don't live in Clearwater. Yeah. I live in Tampa. So
the aquarium was planning on relocating, but they weren't able to raise the funds that they needed, and they decided to continue their expansion instead of on the mainland in downtown, to continue their expansion on Island Estates. So that's what they're in the process of doing.
I stayed over at the Opal.
Opal Sands. Oh, yeah, nice. Beautiful. New property. Yes. Yeah.
We stayed there, it was Memorial Day last year.
Okay.
And we spent a week there. And we got, I didn't realize, my wife rented this room, man. It was nice, beautiful kitchenette. I mean, it just, it was two bedroom. Yeah. It was just huge. So, I mean, Clearwater really has changed in the last 12 years, and I remember it.
The face of Clearwater Beach has changed. Yeah. There are a lot of upscale resort type properties I alluded to earlier that Dr. Patel's Wyndham Grand is going to be opening. The Opal Sands just opened this year. We have the Sand Pearl and the Hyatt. But while we're doing that, we're also remembering that, you know, Clearwater initially was mom and pop type
houses
beach,
used to be right there.
Houses were right there. You know, family, we still want to be considered a family destination.
Yep.
And we are getting some new mid-price family, you know, type hotels, limited service, where you have your room. You don't have the big resort type facilities, massage, you know, spas, banquet facilities. You just have the hotel and just basic service, so that the price point will be much lower than the resorts.
I have people that contact me all the time. Hey, I see an apartment for rent. How close is it to Clearwater?
Yeah.
So those new apartments that are going in are going to really be nice for those people, because they want to be within somewhat walking distance or even bicycling to the beaches, because they want to work down there.
Yeah.
And we have the trails that allow you to bicycle. We've also started a ferry system where you can park free downtown and use the ferry to go to the beach and back, and we would encourage people to consider that option because parking is rather limited, and sometimes we get frustrated with the traffic going to Clearwater Beach, especially during the holiday season and spring break.
Is that a water ferry?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
That road gets backed up. We'll go fishing, and we get caught at the marina there home.
But Matthew, let me tell you a funny story. We were at an event at Ruth Eckert Hall, and it was Kristen Chenoweth, and she said, "Oh, you know, I didn't realize you had problems with traffic in Clearwater," because she was late for rehearsal. And she said, "You know what? I got mad because I was late. And then I looked out my window and I saw the sun setting and boats and dolphin jumping. And I said, you know what? If I'm going to get stuck in traffic, I want to get stuck in traffic on the Memorial Causeway and not on the interstate in some big city where all I see are oil, you know, refineries and just warehouse districts." So that's the plus when you get stuck in traffic in Clearwater. The view is just fantastic.
That's right. Yeah. Clearwater, you know, you got. Now, what if you were to compare and contrast St. Petersburg, you know, because you have a lot of development, and we just talked about in Clearwater. What if you were to contrast St. Petersburg Beach to Clearwater? What's the highlights difference?
Let's clarify. St. Petersburg is a city. St. Pete Beach is a different city.
The beach itself.
St. Pete Beach is beginning to have some new developments on board too. They are next to Clearwater. St. Pete Beach is second in the amount of tourism taxes that are collected through their hotels. So that is also a destination area. But again, you know, when you look at what Visit St. Pete Clearwater does, similar to Visit, you know, Tampa, we're promoting the area. And the advantage that you may have in St. Pete Beach, you know, compared to Clearwater or vice versa, or Tampa to Pinellas County and Clearwater, you know, that's okay, because we need to work together to promote the entire
that's
area.
Right.
And hopefully that's what we're continuing to do. Last year, I mean, we're in the winter season, it's cold. You know, one of the ads that came up last year that Visit St. Pete Clearwater came up with was, it's 20 degrees below 100.
I remember that.
In Clearwater, you know, and think about that. It just makes you feel good to know that, we're 20 degrees below, but it's 100 degrees and not 20 degrees below zero.
Tomorrow night's show, we have Mayor Rick Kreisman of St. Petersburg. Do you want to say anything to him or mention anything?
You know, the neat thing about Mayor Kreisman and Mayor Buckhorn and I, we all have been working together for a lot of years, and while we may have different political hats, you know, he's a strong mayor. Mayor Buckhorn's a strong mayor. We have a city manager for him in Clearwater. Sometimes I may be a little jealous of what they can do because it gets done. Sometimes I think they're probably a little jealous because they don't have to take – that I don't have to take some of the heat that they have to take. but each one of us, whether it's Mayor Buckhorn or Mayor Kreisman or any of our other mayors, I think all of us would agree that the reason this area is such a dynamic area and such an exciting area for the entire country is that we have employees who work for us who every day go out and do their best. And I know, it's just the fad to criticize government that it doesn't do anything. But, most of the time, it's like when you turn on your light switch, the power goes on. Most of the time when you expect water, you get water. When you want your garbage to be picked up, it gets picked up. Yep. And while we may not fix your pothole as quickly as you like, we do get around to doing it. And our employees are dedicated to providing the very best service. And I think all of us would agree and want to thank the employees because they make us look good, just like your employees make you look good.
Absolutely. Yeah. Thanks to all of our listeners. Thanks to all the folks behind the staff here helping us get it done, our partners here in studio. And thank you for coming in as well, Mayor Cretekos and Matthew Fonk as well. Please go out there, consider committing a random act of kindness. Tomorrow night's show, Mayor Rick Kreisman of St. Petersburg on the Consumer Quarterback Show, consumerqb.com.